So Louis de Broglie, I tried to look that up, how to pronounce it, had the thought of symmetry, that if light behaves like a particle, in other words, a pure electromagnetic wave, pure energy, could actually have mass-like properties, then the reverse should be true. And so with that thought, he developed this equation, or it can be derived. It's best probably to read about the derivation in the book, page 836. But what he's saying is a mass-like property, like an electron or a bowling ball, could actually have wave-like properties. This actually helped in development of a new model of the atom to help develop the stable orbits. So if the wave matched up upon itself, then that was a possible stable orbit. But if you look at this one here, where the wavelength is such that it doesn't match up, you get destructive interference. So interesting stuff. So let's digress for a minute and talk about wave properties and particle properties and kind of a summary of both. So we've done reflection with mirrors. Both waves and particles will reflect. And in fact, they also will refract. If you actually were to shoot a bullet into the water, it would bend to the normal and then bend away from the normal. You see this when you're driving your car and get pulled off the road. And we know a wave property of light supports that as well. So this next slide, it's a little blurry for you, but it's a great slide I found on the images on Google of reflection. Both wave and particle are supported. Refraction, just like we showed, both wave and particle. But when you start to get interference, diffraction, and polarization, it's only the wave properties of light that support that. And so we've studied the photoelectric effect. Haven't gone into the details yet why, but it supports the particle theory of light. There's one more that's not shown here, and that's the Compton effect. And so the Compton effect is where, let me see if I can lower this a bit more, is where when you have an incoming like an X-ray coming in, and it collides with an electron, something with mass, so when energy collides with mass, this X-ray gets deflected, but it has a lower energy state. And the fact that it actually changes color, instead of being really bright light to dim light, like bright blue, dim blue, it actually, in essence, changes colors. The wavelength changes, the frequency changes. And so the Compton effect supports the particle theory of light. And what has been derived is an equation that helps explain the shift in the wavelength. So the wavelength afterwards, the change in wavelength, is equal to Planck's constant divided by, here's the mass of an electron, but here we're using the speed of light, divided by, or times 1 minus cosine of theta. So that's the deflection angle. And so you have a constant divided by a constant times a constant. We can summarize all these into 2.43 times 10 to the minus 12th meters. And so when we substitute that back in, we can get our change of wavelength is equal to 2.43 times 10 to the negative 12th meters times 1 minus cosine theta. So again, one more experiment that supports the particle theory of light.